Hello friends, first I would like to thank the organizers of the International Online Mentoring Program, Open Education for a Better World, for giving me this opportunity to prepare and present my OER on Techno-Pedagogical Skills for Sustainable Development. And to introduce myself, I am Dr. Sonam Bansal, working as Assistant Professor at Rawlal Singh College of Education, Sidhravli, Gurugram, Haryana, India. I am the developer of the course and Dr. Sameer Sahasrabuddhi is my STEM Hub coordinator. My mentor is Dr. Fauzi Barood, an Assistant Vice President for Information Technology at Notre Dame University, Lebanon. The journey of the course is very much joyful and useful, not only for the developer but even for the participants. This course has transformed their perception that they can't use technology in their classrooms. In terms of sustainable development goals, this program has succeeded in developing quality education and preparing quality instructors who can now prepare their lectures more effectively using diverse techno-pedagogical skills. The motivation behind choosing this topic is to enable the learners to know how to use technology in teaching and learning. As you know, COVID-19 switched us all to online teaching, but it couldn't be done in a day or two. One could learn to inculcate sustainable development skills among learners. So, this is the major reason why the developer chose this topic for the course development. The goal of this project is to enable the learners to know, to understand and to apply techno-pedagogical skills in learning for quality education at school, college and university level. This course content is offered under a Creative Commons Attribution Shared Alike license. The total number of participants who registered in this course were 1,236 from all over the globe with varying educational levels from graduation to PhD and age groups from 16 to 60. And the active users were 567 and the course was completed by 338 participants. The course was designed for 4 weeks including 4 modules. And the implementation of the course was done on weekly basis, including 1 pre-course and post-course survey with weekly quizzes, including 10 questions in each quiz. Diverse brainstorming activities posted in discussion forums for active participation of learners. To clarify the topic, my mentor, Dr. Fauzi Barood, has given a live webinar on Advancing Open Educational Practices in line with UNESCO OER recommendations. For the development of the course, self-created videos, animated videos, images, PDF, text pages, and free and open resources were used for creating the content. The course was offered on an online learning platform on Canvas. The link of the course has been given here. The main focus of program delivery was on active learning of the participants. Participants who scored over 50% on the quizzes and actively participated throughout the course received the certificate. It makes me very happy to see that 140 participants scored over 90% and they got grade O. And 114 participants got above 50% and they got grade A. The remaining of the participants got a participation certificate. Regarding the challenges, finding and gathering appropriate OERs for the course is difficult for me. The OERs I found were theoretical, so I developed videos and content for my own course. The second major issue was participants' technical glitches. The participants first struggled with the transition from traditional to online learning, but they quickly learned how to successfully integrate technology in their classrooms. Throughout the course progress, my mentor, Dr. Fauzi Barood advised me and supported me. He worked hard with me to help me grow and finish the course. My hub coordinator and Enja ma'am have been really supportive in helping me to develop the course. Regarding the feedback that I have received from the participants was excellent. Participants were very happy and they enjoyed the journey of the course. I feel overwhelmed with the responses of the participants. Many of the participants stated the course was very valuable for the educational community and this course should be repeated regularly. Some participants noted that after this course, they can now take online classes using other technological tools that they didn't know how to utilize before. To further develop this notion, I intend to develop an advanced course on technopedagogy and to implement advanced technopedagogical skills among learners. To benefit and develop how to use technology among learners, I humbly urge that this course be replayed globally. At the end of the course, there was a very happy and good feeling that the journey of this course was very good. I was overwhelmed with the responses of the participants. It was a fantastic and meaningful experience for me. Thank you.